Hello everyone, this is Mitchell from Fred Haas Toyota Country, and today I'm going to be designing what I think a new Toyota MR2 would look like today. Here are my list of inspirations for the vehicles that I'll be pulling from and the specs of the drawing that I'm about to make. And a lot of those specs are averages of those, inspirational vehicles. Mostly I'll be drawing from the 1990 or the second generation MR2. Mostly because I like the style characteristics, although to have a modern vehicle with modern safety features and stuff like that, I will be drawing a lot from the MR2 Spyder, although what I will be making today will be a hard top vehicle. So I'm kind of drawing from style characteristics, like I said, from that 90s one a lot, in the profile. The thing about what I had said when it has my modern safety features is we can't really have pop-up headlights. We can't really have that sort of angular look just because of pedestrian safety laws that require, not spiky or flat or hard features on the front of the vehicle in the case that you strike a pedestrian. Mostly European laws. Although pop-up headlights still do exist on vehicles, they have to be a lot different than the historic versions or the ones in the 80s and 90s. I wanted to put a spoiler as well, just because, that MR2 had a spoiler. I thought it looked cool. And of course, being a mid-engine vehicle, not much of a backseat, gonna be a coupe, that hard top coupe. As I get to the front here, you're gonna see a lot of the MR2 Spyder's characteristics, not with the pop-up or hidden headlights, of course, of the earlier versions. But I did want it to be a hard top, as I think, that would be, in just my personal opinion, pretty cool. Although, since Toyota doesn't really currently have a full convertible, if they were to bring the MR2 back, I think it would be likely that it would at least have a convertible option, if not be convertible 100%. But, this is kind of my inspiration for what I would hope the MR2 would look like, or what I think it might look like. If you also look at that front design, it does have a little bit of that Toyota Celica style lines on the hood. Just wanted to take maybe a small homage there. So designing the back, what will actually happen is I'll design the back and not like it very much, and then in post I'll kind of do a little bit of change, because drawing the spoiler was a little bit difficult for me, admittedly. But we'll come back and I'll take that 1990s MR2 stylization. Here we go. This is what it looks like after the short change and taking the spoiler design, and I'm pointing that out. So now I'm about to pen it, so it'll be easier to scan in, when I put it into the computer, and I'll be able to add like a quote unquote paint job on Microsoft Paint. Yes, I know any designers that are watching this are horrified that I would be using such a rudimentary program, but I'm doing it in a way that, anybody could imitate or anybody could do. Additionally, I do have a video where I talk about how I walk through this process of designing a vehicle this way. If you'd like to do that or check that out, look at our YouTube page. It's like how to design a car. Alrighty, I'm going to be inking this, and then we'll jump over to the computer version pretty soon. I got to erase all the extra lines that I have, and luckily with graph paper, since it's light blue, the grid lines don't pop up very much once you scan it in. So that's what the preliminary design looks like for this vehicle. Lots of MR2 Spyder, lots of MR2 from the 1990s design, and here we are scanned in. What I'm going to do right now is take the curved line tool and just go over a lot of the line work. It's funny, you think you're drawing a straight line with a pencil or a pen, and then once you get it into the system, it looks all jagged and ridiculous just through the scanning in process and the digitalization. But I'll go through just to try to standardize all my lines, and I will be using the paint can tool to paint the vehicle, quote unquote, and you have to have completely enclosed areas in order for that to work correctly. So I'm going to be fast forwarding this pretty quickly. I think that style characteristic in front of the front tire is really cool and reminiscent of sports cars at the time. And once I get around to painting it, which I will do shortly, I wanted to do that MR2 red, from the 1990s or even the original MR2 to pay homage to it. They took a lot of style characteristics back then from both Ferraris and Lotus. I have a few of those through homage to the original MR2s, so kind of the progression of style characteristics. The MR2 from the 90s had this MR2 nameplate on the back, that style characteristic that I'm imitating there, and I'll come back with the text tool and add that to it. Of course, we got our license plate. Yeah, there we go with the text tool. And yeah, of course, got to add a vanity plate. Then I'm going to come through and I'm going to play with one red and then come back and actually make it more red, just because, you know, I want it to be sort of similar to the way the MR2 was. Will Toyota bring the MR2 back? I think out of all sporty vehicles that they have in the repertoire, it's most likely that they'll bring back the MR2 more than any other ones, or more than coming out with a new sports nameplate altogether. So that's why I wanted to design this, maybe trying to predict what it would look like. You know, adding a little bit of variance and color just to make it look 3D. And there it is. That is what I think the MR2 would look like. And I want to hear your thoughts and comments below. Am I way off? Do you think it would look different altogether? Do you think Toyota would never bring back the MR2? I'd really like to hear what you think. So, my name is Mitchell. This is Fred Has Toyota Country, and thanks so much for watching.